workshops. My husband, Dale Axelrod, who's here. Dale, are you staying right here? He's in the control room. He's my technical department. But Dale actually introduced me to Hensche. When we first started dating, he said, oh, you know, I've been going back east to do this workshop. Would you like to come? And didn't tell me it's going to change your life. I was like ready to graduate with a degree in illustration. And he just said, like, you were just going to paint. Well, Hensche kind of completely changed my life. You know, 2 weeks with this man, and I came back to the Academy of Art, and I didn't want to paint. I didn't want to do anything that I had done previously. It's like, okay, well, this is my past art life, and now this is my, you know. And Dale, he actually has a website. He's a great painter. Plainairpainting.com is his website. That's pretty cool, huh? So, anyway, he actually painted much longer than I did. So I really look, and also, he facilitates my workshops, so you kind of get the price, you know, two for the price of one, because Dale has the expertise and the knowledge to really help the students in ways that I maybe can't, or people can see two different approaches to the same, using the same system of painting. And people say color is very individual. It is, but it can be trained. You can be trained in color. See, there's no instruction in color other than like the Hensche or maybe the Sergei people are teaching color. And it can be taught, but if Dale and I did the same scene, we would use completely different colors, but we would arrive at a similar, I mean, we would both be trying to paint the effect of light. And his paintings are very, I call him the Zen Buddhist paintings, painter. His paintings are very minimalist, but, you know.
I must be a very patient man. range. So it was really, you know, those are kind of maybe paintings that are hard to sell. Sometimes it's obvious, but they're all equal. And all five of those were really great paintings picked. Not a single one sold. That's the heartbreak. I think it's, you know, we can learn a lot about art, but we got to have buyers out there, you know, recognize that too.
We have to have an educated buying.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, everybody's talking about their experience in art school. Well, I went to art school in the 70s, and it was Wayne State University, and my instructor, oh, we just wrote through paint. I got a degree in painting and never learned how to paint. And he would say things like, if you don't know who Larry Coons is, you don't know, you're not a painter. And he would regurgitate art for him. And when you come into the studio and critique our paintings, we talk about the peripheral space. And so, one of my fellow students and I, when he walked out, I said, isn't the peripheral space the space around the painting? What exactly was he talking about? I mean, it's like, it was like gobbledygook. It meant nothing. And I think I was right near Chicago. I was right near, and I could study the parks, you know, that Schmidt, Richard Schmidt studied with, and here I was with these. But I didn't know him. Besides, you know, when it comes to drawing in a way is just good judgment. You know, you do enough landscapes, you're going to learn how to draw really well. Basically, is how wide is and how high is something. You don't necessarily have to draw a figure to learn how to draw. You can draw blocks.